Blackstone presents I Can't Breathe, How a Racial Hoax is Killing America by David Horowitz. This book is read by John McLean. To the Victims. Part 1. An American Catastrophe. A Summer of Insurrections. On May 25, 2020, the death of a black American in the custody of Minneapolis police led to one of the greatest eruptions of lawlessness and violence in American history. The violence was provoked by a disturbing video that recorded the last breaths of George Floyd, a Minneapolis citizen who expired with a policeman's knee pressed firmly on the side of his neck for more than 9 minutes. The principal organizer of the protest was a group called Black Lives Matter, BLM, which for 7 years had been conducting similar demonstrations against what it called the systemic racism and brutality of a white supremacist society that targeted black Americans like George Floyd. The protests and riots that followed Floyd's death were so large and destructive, involved so many Americans, and involved such powerful elements of the nation's culture as to reshape its political alignments, affect a presidential election, and inspire the largest exodus from America's cities ever recorded. An earthquake in the nation's human landscape had altered its political and social fault lines for good. Studies by Princeton University and the Wisconsin-based Armed Conflict Location and Event Data Project revealed that during the first 103 days of the unrest, there were 633 violent protests in approximately 220 locations across the United States, including 48 of the 50 largest American cities and 74 of the top 100. Black Lives Matter activists were involved in about 95% of those violent and destructive incidents. According to the studies, there were also approximately 11,400 so-called peaceful protests, which advanced the same Black Lives Matter indictment of America as a systemically racist society at more than 2,400 distinct locations nationwide. During the riots, Black Lives Matter leaders issued no condemnations of the violence, in direct contrast to the civil rights movement leaders of the 1960s, who insisted on the principle of nonviolence and whose demonstrations were not accompanied by attacks on police and the destruction of local businesses. The peaceful protests associated with Black Lives Matter were staged during the daytime and then regularly morphed into riots under cover of night. By illegally blocking traffic on major roadways, the daytime protests created an atmosphere of lawlessness that not only was dangerous in itself, but also contributed to the violence that followed. These facts make it difficult to regard the peaceful protests as distinct and separate from the violence, rather than as fraternal accessories to it. The insurrectionary nature of the Black Lives Matter protests was captured in the principal slogan used by both demonstrators and rioters: No justice, no peace. This could easily be seen as a thinly veiled threat: submit to our views and meet our demands, or face destructive chaos. The chant, No Justice, No Peace, accompanied by such large-scale violence, made clear that the remedy envisaged was not, and could not be, a reform within existing institutions. To make the changes necessary to secure justice, the system must be dismantled first, and then reimagined, to use the in-vogue radical verb. The message was clear: the only acceptable solutions were extreme measures. Only a revolutionary force outside the system could fix it, even though the systems in cities like Minneapolis and all the other major centers of the violence were entirely controlled by liberal Democrats who had endorsed the Black Lives Matter movement. Apparently, those liberals shared the goals of the radicals, but lacked the spine to achieve them. 6 years earlier, Black Lives Matter had instigated similar riots over a similar arrest in Ferguson, Missouri. The principal differences between the civil violence in Ferguson and Minneapolis were scope and scale. The Ferguson street battles, arsons, and lootings were mainly confined to one city and lasted roughly 1 month. But in the intervening years, Black Lives Matter had grown in number and capability to the point where it could now threaten civil order on a national scale. Its increased power was fueled by tens of millions of dollars.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.